say. It's such a feeling that my love I can't hide, I can't hide. Something I think you'll understand when I say that something I wanna hold your hand at my lonely days are over. Life is like a song. Oh, yeah, yeah. At last, the skies above are blue. A dream that I can call my own. I found a thrill to rest my cheek to, a thrill that I
find themselves and then each other. Kelly and Reid have also asked that we take a moment to honor those loved who have touched their lives and are not able to be with us in person today, but are here in spirit. Specifically, Marion and Frank Kelly, Philip DeLong, and Dave Clooney, Kelly's grandparents, and Connie and Nikki Brilio, Reid's grandparents.
Do you hear me talking to you? Across the water, across the deep blue ocean, under the open sky. Oh my, baby, I can.
Boy, I hear you in my dreams. I feel your whisper across the sea. I keep you with me in my heart. You make it easier when life gets hard. Lucky I'm in love with my best friend. Lucky to have been where I have been. I'm lucky to be coming home again. Through the trees move so pretty, you're all I see. As the world keeps spinning round, you hold me right here, right now. I'm lucky I'm in love with my best friend. Lucky to have been where I have been. I'm lucky to be coming home again.
A very special and beautiful thing. That trust and respect can only be sustained if you are both deeply committed to always being open and truthful in every exchange, no matter how small. Encourage them when encouragement is needed and listen to them when they ask for advice. In these ways, you can honor this marriage into which they have become to join today. Do you offer your love and support? Then please turn to each other and share your vows you have written.
Unmistakably. Reid, I promise to give you all of me, to each day show you how much I love you. I promise to listen when you need a friend, so you'll never be alone. I promise to support you through laughter and tears in the largest and smallest of your endeavors. I promise to make your dreams as important as mine. Reid, I promise to always be passionate, to passionately fight with you, and to passionately love you. I cannot promise you that things are always going to be easy, but for every hard time we have, I want to endure with you. For every good memory we make, I want to celebrate it with you. Above all else, I promise to be your best friend and closest companion. I promise to challenge you and encourage you, to laugh at you and to laugh with you. Though the world may change and though we may change with it, I will always love you, always treasure you, and will always share my life and all that I am with you. Wherever our path leads us, it leads us together. I am honored from this day forward to be called your wife.
After me. I give you this ring. It's a sign that I chose you to be my lover, my partner, and my best friend. To the end of my days, wear it and let it be a reminder that I'm always by your side and that I love you. As a sign that I chose you to be my lover, my partner, and my best friend. To the end of my days. And let it be a reminder that I will always be by your side and that I love you. Kelly and Reid, we have heard you promise to share your lives in marriage. We recognize and respect the vows you have made here today before each one of us as a witness. In the honesty and sincerity of what you have said and done here today, and in the accordance with the laws of the state of Maine, it is my honor and delight to declare you henceforth to be husband and wife. You may seal your vows with a kiss. Now may the love that has brought you together continue to grow and enrich your lives. And may you meet with courage the problems that arise to challenge you. And may your relationship always be one of love and trust. May the happiness you share today be with you always, and may every word you have pledged here be a living truth in your lives.
I've been trying to do it right. I've been living a lonely life. I've been sleeping here instead. I've been sleeping on my bed.
You belong with me, you're my sweetheart. I belong with you, you belong with me, you're my sweetheart. Oh, we. Welcome to the family.
Thank you. Glad to be part of it.
I think we did that several years ago.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. for our bridesmaids and grooms. We gotta get everybody clapping their hands. Clap your hands for me as we bring in Melissa Roca and Jeremy Johnson. Gentlemen, now entering to an even bigger round of applause, Connor McCaw and Jay DeMaul. Please now get even louder for Jess Jevons and Lee Murphy. Hey, he's there. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's maid of honor, matron of honor, and best man.
In the hopes that I could get Jeff to read the speech, but I guess my voice is coming back a little bit. What does mother say about daughter, her only daughter, to try to get you all to understand what's been going on with her the last 28 years? Those of you that know me are aware of how important and how special Kelly is to me. She was a precious little girl, and she's become a beautiful young woman. She's sensitive, kind, honest, and funny. She is what you see. There's no false pretenses. She blessed us with many wonderful memories, trips, and sagas as well. We were lucky to know and love her childhood friends who are close to Kelly today. High school and college had their usual share of dramas and traumas, but we wouldn't change anything for a minute. Kelly's the first one I call when I get happy, sad, or anything in was the guy in the class in anatomy that always asked the most ridiculous, long-tailed questions. When most of his friends were rolling their eyes up, Kelly told me she understood. He's a Virgo, just like me, Mom. We're detail-oriented. This is just the tip of the iceberg as to understanding how Kelly and Reid are meant for each other. Kelly has brought a lot of strengths to Reid as he has to her. Kelly's introduced him to her love of dogs and her love of travel. They've rubbed off on Reid, as has Reed's even tempered personality rubbed off on Kelly. 4 years ago tonight, Reid asked Kelly to go steady. We didn't know that term still existed. When she called to give us news, of course, we were thrilled. Our first introduction to Reid was a few weeks or months prior to this, when Reid came to our house for a weekend. Kelly insisted he was just a friend, but we knew differently. We knew there was something more, or would become something more. Call it a mother's intuition or the alignment of the stars, but it was obvious.
Hi. I don't think my part is as funny as Gina's part. I'm sorry for reading it, because if I don't, I'll screw it up totally, and I won't know what to say. But the first 2 years together, you know, they were. They were really studying, man. They were studying hard. There was a head-set grindstone. They had a tough program that they made through physical therapy and, you know, pursuing doctorates in physical therapy. But they still had that spirit of adventure, which they landed internships in South Africa. Seeing some other people live in the rest of the world, man, like, it's invaluable to see how people live today. And what we have here, it's really neat to see them appreciate that. And you know, along the way, they did adopt a rescue dog, Max, who unfortunately cannot be here tonight. As Kelly would say, rescues and Max do have their problems, issues, and so, okay. But anyway, Max became part of our family, all our families, on both sides, and we loved them, and we just appreciated everything that Kelly and Reid have brought our families together and everybody here. But finally, they did graduate from their studies and. Unfortunately, had left Florida to pursue a career in Olympia, Washington, which they got great, great offers to, so they couldn't refuse. And unfortunately, things turned out and brought them back here to the East Coast. So that's where we stand today. But.
Hey, Jeff, that was great. That's great.
Next move was to Portland, Maine, which of course we were thrilled with. But even before they moved to Portland, they decided on a main venue for their wedding. And as you look outside, I'm sure you all understand why we were excited. And it's just a perfect, beautiful scenery for a wedding. Our only hesitation was that this is kind of a destination wedding. And we were so afraid that a lot of their close friends and family wouldn't make it. Little did we know the depth and scope of their friendships. Four of the sexy seven are actually in the wedding party, as are many of Reid's grade school friends. We have high school friends, college friends. We think it takes really good intentioned, honest, fun, loyal people to maintain these kind of friendships. And I guess we basically just want to say we thank you so much for making this trip, even under difficult circumstances, to be here with us tonight. And Kelly and Reid, I'm sure, would agree. We just really want to extend ourselves to thank you for being here. We needed every one of you. So if you would, I'd ask you to stand up. Most wonderful daughter a mother could ever ask for, and the most amazing son-in-law anyone could ever ask for. Here's to Kelly and Braylia.
Thank you, Shannon. Thank you, Jeff.
My name is Jill, and I'm Kelly's maid of honor, for those of you who don't know already. And I've known Kelly since kindergarten. It has been such a journey watching her go from a little kid to her wedding day. My earliest memory of Kelly is holding hands on the first day of second grade, clinging to her for dear life, like I was not going to make it through that day without her there beside me. And now, 20 years later, more than 20 years later, I still feel the same way. Like, I would not want to go through life without a friend like Kel by my side. Kelly has always been one of the most loyal friends. She has stuck by me through some of our lowest points and has loved me anyway. Even after the time when we were in the fourth grade and we were auditioning for Community Theater's production of Annie, and I sang I Got a Crow from Peter Pan. And probably kept us both from getting cast, me for my fearless crowing, and you for being associated with me. Or the times we would dance in the field across the street from our elementary school crush's house, shamelessly to Cyndi Lauper's Girls Just Wanna Have Fun, blasting on the boombox, thinking it would end with him professing his undying love for both of us. It never did. And it's a good thing our preteen dance moves didn't work their magic on our crush with the bowl cut, because then Kelly would have never met Reid. See, Kel, everything happens for a reason. I knew it had nothing to do with our dance moves. Yes, through many, many moments of embarrassment and poor decision-making, Kelly has stuck by me. She has always been there to be my voice of reason, to remind me never to take myself too seriously, and that sometimes laughter is the best and only medicine. She's always been one of the bravest people I know, unafraid to follow her heart, to travel the world, to move clear across the country, twice, to be herself. Through all the changes and challenges life has thrown at her, she's always had an amazing sense of who she is, what she wants, and how to stay true to herself. I've always admired you for that, Kel. You make it look so easy. Reid, I couldn't have hoped for Kelly to meet a better man for her than you. You are one of the kindest, most patient, easy on the eyes men I've ever met. And I can see how much you love our Kel. I know you would do anything for her. I couldn't really pick out a single moment to show how amazing of a human being you are. Oh, except for that one time when you guys were driving in the pouring rain on the highway and the car in front of them lost control and flipped over on its side onto the median, and Reid turned into Superman right before Kelly's eyes. The next thing Kelly knew, Reid was pulling a baby out of the car that had turned over on its side. Kelly is married. Clark Kent, everybody. Clark Kent. Seriously, I am so happy that you two have found each other, and I know know you're going to have a long and happy life together. To Reid and Kelly.
Thank you, Jill. Ladies and gentlemen, I now need a big round of applause for tonight's best man, Adam Berman.
So, I wrote a few words, just so I didn't forget. I've never done this, my first try, so... Wow, what a wonderful day it's been. Turns out, Maine isn't how I thought it would be. There's no air conditioning. First off, I'd like to toast the following for helping make today possible. Janet and Jeff Clooney, Joel and Genevieve DeLong, Paula and Ron Wenger, and Kim and Joe Brody. Ah, Reid. I'm told that during the best man speech, I'm supposed to sing your praises and tell all the great qualities about you. Well, unfortunately for all of us, I can't sing and I won't lie. I want to start by giving you a special congratulations because you made it here on time. You made it here on time, not on Brilliant Time. And Kelly, congratulations to you because you are entering a new realm of time. It's called Brilliant Time and you're never really late. Other people are just early. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Adam and I've had the fortunate pleasure of knowing Reid since we were about 9 years old. Don't let him fool you, he wasn't always this put together suave guy with his pen to books and everything figured out. Had his head in the clouds for a long, long time. But to that point, I think it's my duty and privilege to tell you about that journey that led him to this beautiful girl, Kelly. Sorry? So my relationship with Reid started over a shared love of Taco Bell and baseball. We were playing travel baseball all over the state of New Jersey, and after every game we'd won, we'd head to Taco Bell with our parents. Safe to say that we had the menu memorized by about July. Trips to baseball games soon turned to trips down the shore to his wonderful grandparents' house, who I'm sure are with us in spirit while they cannot be here. They did tell me to tell you to not be a goof. And don't mess this up, because she's a great girl. So Reid has always been a little bit more adventurous than me. Well, maybe we could say less caring about the outcome of events. He was a shoot first, ask questions later kind of guy. Okay? I sat through my share of lectures from his parents about things that he or we had done wrong. And to that point, there was one specific incident that I feel it's my duty to share. His father, Joe, had this saying about a bucket of stupid. And the bucket of stupid was something that boys had and they carried with them at all times. They would go everywhere with this bucket. Every time they were about to make a bad decision and think, maybe I shouldn't do this, we would sure enough just reach in the bucket, put a little bit in our pocket, and we'd carry on with that decision. So, one thing led to another and we ended up in the hot seat or the kitchen. And the light was on, and we'd be sitting in the kitchen, and he would say, cheese and crackers. You boys were dipping in the bucket of stupid again, and you took a big old swig of it. Naturally, Reid and I looked at each other like Joe was speaking French. I don't know what he's talking about, do you? No. So what? We had a couple friends over. Joe was out of town. Those friends called some more friends. We called some more friends. And before we knew it, somebody got a keg, and... Next thing we know, the police department was there. I said, hey boys, what are you guys doing? And we said, oh, you know, everyone's just going home. You guys missed it. So sure enough, everyone left, and it was just Reid and I.
Holding the bucket.
It was more like a dump truck then. So, you know, a couple years pass, and Joe sells the house, and, you know, and he's selling the house, and they're doing a walkthrough, and I'd asked Reid before that, I said, hey, you got rid of that keg, right? Oh, yeah, it's gone. Well, sure enough, the keg's in the backyard. 2 years after that fateful night. But as great as Reid is, there's a few more facts I'd like to share about him. He owns 3 swimming records at our local swimming club. He sings like a Backstreet Boy. He can play the guitar like Eric Clapton. And some other facts. His nickname is Baby Huey. because he's worse than a bull in a china shop when he gets excited. He likes to smell everything. Ellie, I'm sure you can attest to that. Now, he has the privilege of marrying the beautiful Kelly, who is also incredibly intelligent, was a valedictorian of PT school.
Thank you.
That's ironic on two different levels, that she's so beautiful and smart, and Reed's just beautiful. But, you know, they both have their doctorate degrees, and that's incredible, but Reid once had a 0.84 grade point average that landed him back in that hot seat in Cherry Hill, New Jersey. He also once passed himself off as a male model at that college where he had the 0.84 GPA. And one last story is that his first night at IU, where he went for undergrad, I was so sad that he was leaving, and I didn't know what I was going to do on weekends because he was no longer around. And first Tuesday, he called my house at 2:30 in the morning and spoke to my mom. He said, "College is great, it's so much fun." And my mom said I couldn't go to school with him. So all these things that later... You remember that, don't you? All these things that laid the groundwork for what Kelly has fallen in love with. Reid met Kelly in PT school and he called me one night. It was normal time. And he said, "Dude, I met this great girl. She's so smart. She's beautiful." I go, "Oh, I can't wait to meet her." As the relationship evolved, so too did Reid. He would speak often about their trips and their plans and how they were moving to South Africa and Washington. And I was waiting to see him on House Hunters one time. And one of the coolest things about everything was he said how great Kelly's family had treated him. And they had taken him in. And, you know, Reid had another set of parents who were just so great to him. Out of the blue one day, he called me up and he goes, "It's time." I go, "Oh man, what does that mean?" He goes, "It's time, she's the one. Let's look at rings when I come home." The rest is history. I've never seen Reid in a better place, either professionally or personally. Kelly, you are what he needs. You have to keep him in line, or else it's gonna be one outlandish idea after another. Seeing the two of you so happy and so in love makes all of us so happy. It's not often that we can see the ones that we care so much about so, so happy. I think I speak for everyone when I say thank you for letting us be a part of your special day. Reid, despite everything, I've admired you since we were about 10 years old. You were a better baseball player than me at the time, so... But really, you've always been so concerned about everybody else and so caring and so loving and so selfless. And it's great to see that you found someone that has those same viewpoints, and you guys are just incredible together. Kelly, you're beautiful, you're smart, you're caring, you're doing well. What does that say? You're loving, you're funny, you're beautiful. I think I might have said that already. You're the total package. It's great. Kelly, come over here, please. It's with great pleasure that I can hand you the bucket of stupid.
It's gotten a lot smaller.
It will never be empty. But it was once a dump truck, it was once an ocean, a lake, and now look how small it's gotten. And it's all because of you. I love you both. And so happy ever after.
Thank you, Adam. Ladies and gentlemen, please a nice round of applause for Mr. Joel DeLong.
You've heard about the wanderlust, right? The South Africa, the Washington State, Maine. I mean, these two really like to get around. But the fact is, they're both from Jersey, right? And let me focus on the girls right now. Jersey girls are the most beautiful, the hottest babes that there are. You can talk about California girls. You can talk about girls from Ipanema. But Jersey girls are the best. Reid knows it. Just for a little, and all of our bridesmaids here, I think, are Jersey girls, right? And are they beautiful? And in fact, let's just do a little poll here, a little scientific poll. Doesn't matter what age you are, but if you're a female and you spend a little time in New Jersey and you consider yourself a Jersey girl, raise your hand, please. There you go. These are the Jersey girls. Look at them. Beautiful. Right? Well, the fact is, you can take the Jersey girl out of Jersey, but you can't take the Jersey out of the Jersey girl. And they keep coming back. Okay, so when we remodeled our house, we put a little extra room in there. We put a bathroom in there in the hope that Kelly and Reid and other members of our family would keep coming back to the house. And in fact, you know you've got a key. It works in the door. You use it any time. You come into the house. You get yourself a little fix of Jersey. You head off to wherever you're going to go, but keep coming back and refilling on that Jersey attitude, right? You're welcome anytime. We'll do anything we can for you. We love you. We want you with us as much as you can be. We know, you know, you're busy. But the thing we're looking forward to most, and this may be a little premature, is babysitting.
You have a couple years, Joel.
Thank you, Joel. And where is Mr. Carroll Pickens, grandfather of the Grove?
I was thinking about what to say, and there are many similarities between Kelly and the lady I married. First of all, they're both beautiful. Secondly, they excel in academics. They're very bright people. Thirdly, Reid and I are very lucky that they decided to marry us. I was in college, and my fraternity brother said, you do the dating, but you don't date any Chi Omegas. And I said, no, I've been busy. And he said, we would like to double date with you sometime. So he said, who would you like to date with? And the New Year's college yearbook came out, and there was a picture of a lady that was selected by the editor of Esquire magazine. Some of you may not know it. However, I said, I'd like to date Connor, Phyllis Connor. He arranged the date. We went out to dinner, and as we were getting out of the car to return the girls to the sorority house, Peggy, the other girl, said, you two are going to get married. I liked the idea, but it took 3.5 years at least for that to happen. I graduated ahead of her, and I got a commission in the Navy when I graduated. And I went to my ship, which was a heavy cruiser in the Pacific. It was stationed out of Long Beach. She called me up and said, let's get married. We'll make a lot more money so that we can have some money when you go to graduate school. That made sense. I arranged leave, I came home. We did get married. We had a 3-week honeymoon in California before my ship went to the Western Pacific, which happened to be the flagship of the whole Pacific. Pretty good duty. And we were home for 3 weeks, and I left. 6 months later, I came back. 9 months later, a lady named Paula was born. Paula happens to be the mother of Reid. Therefore, if we hadn't, thanks to the Navy, come home, we wouldn't be here tonight. So, we've had a great marriage. We have 4 children, all married, all happy, 9 grandsons, 4 granddaughters, and a great grandson, thanks to Connor, Paula's daughter. Marriage is an interesting institution, and it's Phyllis describes it with a rubber band. Everything that was said today is so true, but feelings come and go and stretch, but the rubber band doesn't break. It's important. And for that reason, 6 months from now, exactly to this date, Phyllis and I will have been married for, we'll start our 60th year. Marriage is great. We led a ball. We worked at it, and that's what it takes. So, Reid and Kelly, do your duty.
Thank you, Mr. Pickens. Ladies and gentlemen, your first course will be out.
Because I was wearing bright blue.
How are you there at the exact right moment?
Hold it up.
You gotta go.
Balls to the wall, Kelly. Bang it out. Let's go. Come on, girlfriend.
Come on.
Is that 6 cents?
Sal, this is the absolute. This is. Wait, just turn around.
I like.
Please turn around real quick, Sal. Look at that view.
Look at that. Right.
Okay. Does it get any better?
All right, Sal, come back here.
Now to us again.
No. Come back, Sal.
Hi.
This is the absolute best day of our lives. All right.
We'll never get better than this.
The one thing that makes it the best is that the people around us. And Kelly has the absolute best friends in the world.
Best.
I literally feel like I've known you my entire life. And it is absolutely wonderful. So thank you so much. Thank you.
Yeah.
All right. I love this girl. All right. We're gonna spend at least 4 lifetimes together, maybe 5.
Yes, we are.
All of us.
We're gonna grow very old. We're gonna buy 1 big house.
I think I'm gonna cry.
I'm gonna buy that island out there. We're gonna put a huge house on it.
Yeah.
Woo!
You heard it first.
I'll be a come
we'll
a lobster.
We'll be there.
First, right here.
Yeah.
Right.
You're gonna videotape it while we're up there.
Fox.
Are you 2 favorite girls?
Click.
Ever.